Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for what has been a very highly requested video over the years, to be honest. I feel that the requests have picked up of late because a lot of you, myself included, are struggling to read, but it's definitely been one that continuously crops up whenever people mention videos they want to see, and that is, of course, as the title already tells you, books to get you out of a reading slump. Now, I did want to say a couple of things before I got into the books themselves. One is that a lot of the time there's a reason you're in a reading slump. Life can be really stressful, and it's completely okay to be in a reading slump. In fact, maybe the whole term reading slump is incredibly unhelpful, I don't know. Someone, I'm sure, could do a much better analysis of this, but maybe it makes you feel worse because you don't always have to be constantly reading, you don't always have to be reading in great volumes. Allow yourself to feel whatever you're feeling. It's okay to not read as much for a period of time, regardless of how long that time is, and you don't need to beat yourself up about it. On the flip side, however, as somebody who has definitely had peaks and troughs in their own reading, I mean, for example, quite a few years back now, more than 10 years ago, I didn't read a single new book for pleasure for at least 4 years, and it was BookTube that got me back into reading, and I'm so grateful for it because of that. Because in that case, the reading slump had sort of descended into me forgetting about the joy of reading and losing the joy of reading. And it was BookTube that reintroduced me to that joy of reading. So as much as I recognize sometimes the internet and BookTube included can be a space that we tend to compare ourselves to others in, I also just think involving yourself in a bookish community, talking to other people about books, can actually be the most conducive thing to get you out of a reading slump. So with that said, let's now get on to the actual books themselves that I think for one reason or another may help you if you are trying to reinvigorate your reading a little bit. Now, another note I will make is that I myself find if I'm slumping a little bit with my reading that I would tend towards reading an old favourite, and that might help me out of my slump. One of those that I've read over and over and over again and I always come back to is Going Postal for Terry Pratchett. Obviously it's my familiarity with this book that makes it such a good book to end a reading slump for me, but I also think part of it is the comedic aspect of it, and for that reason I definitely wanted to include a little bit of comedy. So instead of like focusing on a book I've talked about a lot and is a book I've reread many, many times, I wanted to mention The Portable Door by Tom Holt, because this is a book when I picked up that I literally was cackling from page one, and yes, I do mean cackling. I only had to read a few paragraphs of this book to find myself laughing out loud, and I think that ability of a book to ignite laughter in a reader is actually really helpful when you're struggling to read, because it stops you taking yourself as seriously, it stops you taking literature necessarily as seriously as you might, and also laughter is an incredible stress relief. So stress is one of the reasons you're not reading, then laughing at a book is probably going to help with that. This is a fantasy novel set in the modern day at a massive London firm where a young mortal man gets a new job. He doesn't really understand why he's been hired, he's not particularly qualified, but it doesn't take long for him to realise that this firm is not as it seems, and there are quite a few employees as well as tasks involved in his daily work life that are somewhat supernatural, and I'll say no more than that. Something else that I also feel like has a little bit of joy, a little bit of laughter and a little bit of levity to it, although it's maybe not like roll on the floor laughter, it's more of like a comforting, relatable humour, is Giant Days. Now this is actually a comic book series, and this is another just tip I would give if you're in a reading slump. I know not everyone reads comic books. A lot of people associate comic books with superheroes and they're maybe not into superheroes, but I would just like to vouch wholeheartedly for both comic books and graphic novels here. I'm not into superheroes, but there's so many wonderful comic books out there that do not fall into that genre that I think it is definitely worth doing a little bit of digging to find what works for you. And I love Giant Days because it again is set in the contemporary world. It's a completely contemporary story about three friends who meet in their freshers week at university and their journey as university students together in the UK, in Britain. And like I said, it's very relatable, it's very lighthearted, it's very comforting, and it is just a quick, fast, fun read. On the topic of quick, fast and fun, I think thrillers can be excellent if you're in a reading slump because they can be very compelling in terms of their plot, but I also think a YA thriller is a great place to look because they're often quite fast and easy, and those are not bad things. It's a skill to write an excellent, fast-paced, fun, easy, relatable thriller. So I wanted to recommend to you A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson, and I am now realising I'm not holding that book up, am I? This is the sequel, Good Girl, Bad Blood. I will insert a picture of book one in this series, but it is a YA thriller series about a teenage girl named Pip in the UK, although I believe the US editions have the books set in the US as well, who ends up embroiled in solving a cold case related to her hometown, and they are so well plotted, the narrative is so compelling, and there is mystery upon mystery that keeps you turning the pages. I did want to mention two other books that definitely have mystery plots that are definitely thriller adjacent but also very much fit into separate genres themselves. The first one is The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle by Stuart Turton. Now this is actually quite a chunky novel and it's quite a dense novel, so it might not immediately strike you as something that would be good for a reading slump. But some of us, depending on what kind of reading slump we're currently experiencing, need a dense, absorbing, epic kind of book that we're just going to spend a lot of time with, that's really going to wrap us up in it and is not going to be over super quickly. Whereas there are definitely quite a few short books I'm going to talk about soon. This one is a mystery but it has a paranormal twist. It is about a man who wakes up every morning in the body of a different guest at the same party on the same day. So he is reliving this same day over and over and over again, piecing the clues together that he uncovers in order to figure out who murdered Evelyn Hardcastle. But obviously there is a secondary mystery to that, which is why on earth is he reliving this day? Where has the supernatural element of the story even come from? If you would like something a little bit shorter though, if you do prefer a bit of literary fiction, if you really, really appreciate beautiful, beautiful prose, and that's going to be the kind of thing that's going to absorb you and reinvigorate your reading, then I'd suggest reading The Majesties by Tiffany Tsao. So this book is about a Chinese Indonesian family and the sole survivor of that family when her sister commits mass murder at a family gathering and poisons everyone there. She's the only person to survive, but she is in a coma. And we flip between her thoughts in her coma, her observations as she hears what people around her are saying, and her sort of trying to figure out why her sister did this, as well as the history of her family, the story of her and her sister, their relationship, what they went through together. And what I found so intriguing about this novel was that often I forgot about the coma side plot. I forgot where we were going because I was so absorbed in the moment. I was so fascinated by this family, by these characters, and the little mysteries of this book that it would almost take me aback every time I was reminded that there was this whole other storyline, and that for me was very compelling. And I feel in that respect the book offers multiple opportunities to hook you in and to help you sort of escape to literature once again. Now my next recommendation is actually a short story collection, and it is New World Fairy Tales by Cassandra Parkin. Now I love a good short story collection, but for me some short story collections you read over a long period of time, taking little breaks in between each story, and others you read all in one go because you become consumed by the themes of the whole collection. And for me that was what this was, which is why I think it might make a good one if you're in a reading slump. Firstly, you do have those breaks in the stories, so it feels like less of a commitment. You can read each story in your own time, you can get a feel for what you are getting into, and you can just sort of relax and take your time with it, which might be exactly what you need when you're in a reading slump. But equally, I think that these are such unique, interesting retellings of traditional fairy tales that it can become quite consuming, that it becomes very compelling as an entity in itself, and there is a loose thread tying each story together which helps make it that whole, plus absolutely stunning writing, and that never hurts. For me personally though, there's nothing quite like a historical romance when I'm in a reading slump. If I've not read anything for a few weeks, if I'm struggling to focus on one genre or another, then a historical romance is always there for me. I find them so fast-paced, so quick, so absorbing, so endearing, and I become so invested in the characters if it's a good one, if I like it, and that's exactly what I need. So I thought I would include one here for those of you that might be inclined that way, and that is 9 Rules to Break When Romancing a Rake. This is about a young woman in 1800s London who's approaching 30, and she is seen as a bit of a spinster. She is sort of being seen as put on the shelf and past the marriageable age, and a little bit I were and uninteresting and uninspiring, which honestly is everybody else's problem because she is absolutely phenomenal. And she decides to take her own life into her hands. She's sort of told herself that she's never going to get married or fall in love or fulfill those expectations as a young woman in Victorian or Regency society. But she can try out some of the things that she's always wanted to have a go at, including smoking a cheroot and fencing and kissing a roguishly handsome duke who may or may not end up helping her on her adventure. You may or may not have realised, but I myself am actually struggling to read as much at the moment, as quickly as the moment, or find books that I love as much as the moment. And my next recommendation is actually inspired by the book that is giving me the comfort I need right now in a little bit of a slump, and that is Nevermore, The Trials of Morrigan Crow by Jessica Townsend. So this is book one in the series, and I'm currently listening to the audiobook of book three. Absolutely loving it. It's exactly what I need, and I would say that for the series as a whole thus far. This is a middle grade series, which I think, again, the sort of fast-paced, easier nature of middle grade for adults can make it the exact kind of thing that you need when you're in a reading slump. But that does not mean it is any less complex, any less well written, any less full of adventure and mystery than an adult book, and I think anyone of any age could absolutely fall in love with this series. Middle grade in general, I think, is perfect if you're in a reading slump, but this is one that I think will appeal to so, so many who have fond memories of children's fantasy as a kid themselves, because this book will take you back to that nostalgia. It will give you that feeling that you felt as a kid, and it is so wonderful. Now, it wasn't intentional, but I have managed to leave two books to last on this list that are both published by the same publisher and are both short sci-fi novellas. So again, maybe a big book is what you need, but I know a lot of us probably just need the satisfaction of finishing a book to be inspired to pick more up. We need to build that momentum, and therefore short books are exactly what we need. And these two, I think, would make perfect places to go. First up is All Systems Red by Martha Wells. So this one is set in space, and it is about an android cyborg. I'm not sure the best sort of robot slash human name for them, but they refer to themselves as Murderbot. They are security for hire for ships who may need security on their team. They do their job, they get on with it, they save humans' lives, but all they really want to do is sit in their little room and watch soap operas on their television set or the equivalent in the future. And it is so relatable, that sort of fed up with the world, fed up with humanity state of mind, just wanting to get caught up in a story, to travel to another world that you're not even a part of and just watch the lives of characters unfold, is something I'm sure a lot of us are familiar with and maybe exactly what you need to read about when you're in a reading slump. I then also wanted to mention Binti in this video by Nnedi Okorafor, which is another Tor novella set in space. But in this instance, we follow the first human to be accepted at this intergalactic university for alien races across the universe. And her family are a little bit reticent to the idea of her going to this university because they don't like to leave their planet. They feel their energy is better spent on Earth. And for that reason, she ends up sneaking away to travel to this university. But on her journey, things go a little bit awry, and I will say no more. But for such a short book, there are quite a few little twists and turns in there, which I think is fantastic. And it doesn't take long for you to become very emotionally invested in the characters' lives. Those are the 10 books I thought might be of aid in getting you out of your reading slump. I hope one of them piqued your interest, but do remember to take care of yourself and not to let anybody else make you feel bad about yourself, including yourself. And I will see you all again in the next one. Happy reading. Bye, guys.